Hi guys, in this lesson, I'm going to cover the deployment of gateway load balancers. Now you'll remember that when we talked about the different types of load balancer that are available, there's one called a gateway load balancer. You use the gateway load balancer when you want to load balance connection requests to backend instances that are running IDS software, IPS software, or next generation firewalls. So let's have a look at how we can deploy a gateway load balancer. In this case, we have a VPC and an application subnet. This is where all of our applications are running. We then have an appliance subnet. So it's a separate subnet that's dedicated for our appliances. We've got our applications running in our app subnet, and then we've got the firewall appliances running in the appliance subnet. We then deploy a gateway load balancer and a gateway load balancer endpoint. We have an internet gateway attached to the VPC. Now the GLB endpoint is a target in the subnet route table. So let's have a look at the routing here. Of course, we have a destination with a local target. That's for the VPC side of block itself. Then what we're saying is for all other traffic, so anything going out to the internet, for example, we want to route to the gateway load balancer endpoint address. So this would be the ID of the gateway load balancer endpoint. So our connections will now go to the gateway load balancer endpoint through the gateway load balancer, and then they'll get routed to the backend instances which are running our firewalls. And then from there, they can go out to the internet. Now the return traffic is going to come back from the internet. And what we want to do is use a gateway route table that's attached to our internet gateway so that we can direct the return traffic via the gateway load balancer endpoint. So in this case, what we're doing is saying that anything that has a destination of 10.0.1.0/24, which is the app subnet, go via the gateway load balancer endpoint. So it's going to hit here, it's going to get load balanced through the firewall appliances. And from that subnet, there's no gateway load balancer endpoint, of course, because all we want to do now is route internally. So we use the local route, and it's going to route the connections to the EC2 instances. So now we've got the firewalls acting for the traffic that's going out and coming back in again. A gateway load balancer works with AWS auto scaling. So you can have an auto scaling group of your firewalls or your IDS systems or IPS systems. Now it's often used with third-party virtual appliances. That includes next generation firewalls, web application firewalls, intrusion detection systems, and intrusion prevention systems. And it enables high availability by routing traffic to healthy appliances. The gateway load balancer endpoints that we saw in the diagram are powered by private links, so you can think of them as VPC endpoints. When creating a target group, you need to choose the Genève protocol. So you'll see this with the 6081 port number when you select that when you're creating your target group. The target type can be instances or IP addresses. So you have those two options when you select your instances for inclusion as appliances behind your load balancer. We'll cover a few things about monitoring your gateway load balancer. There are CloudWatch metrics, and the AWS Gateway ELB namespace includes quite a few metrics. You can also use VPC flow logs, so you can create a flow log for each network interface for the GLB, one per subnet, and that will capture the traffic, and you can store that in an S3 bucket, and then you've got that information to use for whatever analytics you want to use. And lastly, CloudTrail logs will capture the API actions relating to your GLB.